Heaviest of the rain continuing to wind down over the next few hours, while a few additional inches of snow are going to be a possibility in areas that have been mostly snow, and a wet snow in far northern areas with temperatures between 30 and 35. As we go later into the morning and into the afternoon, we are expecting the wind pick up behind this front. With clearing skies, we'll look for winds to gust over 30 to 35 miles an hour this afternoon. The latest look at this just after 8 a.m. showing it is mainly rain south of the White Mountains and a little bit of light snow trying to develop up in some western areas of the state, while the light snow will continue to be focused up north for a few additional hours. You can clearly see a back edge and the wind that will be building in behind that later on this morning and into the afternoon. You can see by the time we get to the evening commute, some lingering light snow up north with partial clearing elsewhere. This will be with the wind gusting over 30 to 35 miles an hour this afternoon, eventually dropping into the teens and 20s later tonight. Could be on some untreated surfaces, some slippery spots overnight tonight and first thing tomorrow morning. Otherwise, it's sunshine tomorrow, mid 30s to mid 40s, a lingering breeze out of the southwest, and then a front approaching later on Wednesday, and that will have some scattered snow showers with it. That really the only system between now and all the way through the weekend as it stands. With most of the computer maps, it does leave us with some chillier temperatures on Thursday and then a warming trend heading into the weekend. As far as the highest snowfall totals up north, where this has been mostly snow and a very wet snow, that's probably your best chance with any sort of gusts over 30 miles an hour to see some additional outages later on this afternoon. There's your 7-day forecast, which has a chill back into the air for late Wednesday and Thursday, and then a warming trend for the weekend.